What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Rated Exyllent. My name's Exy, and this is my little corner of the internet where I can talk about video games, movies, TV, whatever the fuck I feel like talking about. And today is January 1st, 2024, new year, bunch of new shit to do. So I figured for this episode, I'm going to lay out just a quick roadmap of the next few episodes that I want to get done here on the podcast. As well as, I literally just finished Sonic Superstars like 20 minutes ago. So I'm going to go over a review of that. And, I don't know, maybe some 2024 predictions. Because, you know, that's what all the fancy YouTubers and the Twitch people and the podcasters do. I ain't doing no New Year's resolutions. That's a segue to... That's probably... going to be a topic of an upcoming episode is why New Year's resolutions are stupid. Plus, I want to do some more game reviews. I finished TMNT Shredder's Revenge. I talked a little bit about that in the last episode, but I didn't really go in depth like a review should be. And that's, I mean, that was just kind of, I finished it. I wasn't really blown away by it. I just talked about it briefly. Let's see. I also need to do the little 5 mini episodes to fill the gaps while I was away for 5 weeks. And I need to talk about some TOC stuff that I've been talking about doing since like the first real episode or the second real episode. But that right there is a quick little roadmap of what I'm planning to do. Let's jump into Sonic Superstars. Let me pull up this window right here. So it was released just a couple of months ago, October 17th, 2023. On Metacritic. And then, you know, the big fancy critics, they give it a 73, which is, I don't know, it's like a... What is that, like a C? And people who have played it give it an 8.8. Me? I don't know. I'm probably leaning in more with the critics' review. It didn't really blow me away. Honestly, as a follow-up to Mania, I was really excited for it. But I don't really like what it is. The overall world map has got like a Sonic Generations feel to it, which I do like. And the 2.5D, I'd really rather just have the pixel art. I'd really rather it have just been a Mania 2. Honestly, the Chaos Emerald powers that you get, like being able to turn into water or whatever, that's just really gimmicky and stupid. I do like the idea of being able to play as either Sonic or Knuckles or Tails or Amy. Even this new character, Trip, that you get after beating it. I played a couple levels right quick. There's something there, but I don't think this was the game for it. Now, I didn't play the co-op. Maybe that's where this game shines. Is, you know, if you have 4 people on screen... playing together. I don't know. Maybe it does something different. But honestly, it just seemed like they tried to redo the same Sonic formula that they keep doing. That Mania kind of broke the mold on, but also kept. It did enough new stuff to where it felt like a new game, but it didn't break so far away that it was just like, this could have been any other platformer with any other name on it. I mean, it could have been Bubsy or Crash Bandicoot, honestly. The levels in it were, I mean, they were just alternate versions of every other Sonic level we've ever had. I mean, they had a flying Sky Sanctuary like one with it was, I don't know, Golden Castle or something. I don't remember the names, which that's another thing. It's not very memorable. Trying to find a list of the level names, but I don't see it, and honestly I don't care that much to find it. But yeah, that Golden Castle or Golden Desert, whatever it was, I mean, that was very reminiscent of Sky Sanctuary. They had a frost palace or something like that. I mean, that was your I want to be Ice Cap zone. Press Factory. That one was interesting because you constantly had this thing in the background, and when it would slam down, it would make Sonic, you know, lift up in the air, like almost like a mini earthquake type thing. That one was interesting. The second part of it, though, was just like the Sandopolis Act 2, where you constantly have to be pushing this button instead of a switch to keep the level from blowing up. That one was, like I said, it was very Sandopolis 2 or Oil Ocean 2 from Sonic Mania, where if you don't keep up with this timed gimmick, the level just explodes and you die. The Chaos Emerald zones were annoying as fuck. Actually, I couldn't even get the last Chaos Emerald because I don't understand really how you're supposed to gain any type of momentum. Like, I've tried. It's like this weird, I don't know, like you Indiana Jones whip and swing, or Spider-Man swing on these balls in space. But if you do it like a half swing, you do seem to go faster, but you don't go nearly as high. But it doesn't really seem to matter how fast you go, because as you speed up, the emerald speeds up. So you got to go in these little shoot things that will help you catch up to them. But I cannot figure out any rhyme or reason as to how you actually lock on to the thing that you want to collect or swing from. Because you got to collect rings too. That's your timer, of course. And as the, I think it was like right around after you get the fourth emerald, they start adding bombs in there. And I didn't really pay enough attention to tell whether when you hit a bomb, do you lose rings or does it just kill your momentum? But at one point in the last one, I mean, there's just so much going on that I can't figure out the pathway to follow to get the white emerald. So I guess I'll never know what this magic power that one has. Just another thing. These fucking Chaos Emerald powers, they were stupid. Turn into water, grow a bush, become a fireball. It's like, I haven't played Sonic Colors yet, but it's like they wanted to bring back the Wisps without bringing back the Wisps. That's a hard word to say, Wisps. But ultimately, when it comes to Sonic Superstars, I guess if you're a Sonic fan, play it for the sake of playing it. But as far as, like, will I ever play this game again? Probably not. I don't even think I'll ever go and finish the new character Trips story, because once you beat the main story, then you get like a quote-unquote encore mode, but with Trip. Levels are a little remixed. You still have all the Chaos Emeralds that you got in the main story. So, if you find another big ring in any of the levels, you can keep racking up the emeralds that you haven't collected, which for me is just the white one. I redid Bridge Island Zone, and that is probably where I'm gonna leave it. She did have this cool, I guess it's a she, but like her double jump allows her to attach to the wall very much like, I think it was the Pink Wisp, where you kind of like become a buzzsaw and you can ride on the walls and up on the ceiling. So I'm sure there are some interesting locations you can reach with that. But like I said, I'm just not super interested in replaying the entire game with a new character just for the sake of being able to say that I did it. They brought back, depending on how you know him, it's either Fang the Hunter or Knack the Weasel. The only reference I know to him was Knack the Weasel from Sonic Triple Trouble on Game Gear. But I guess in Sonic the Fighters, he was called Fang. I don't know. But that was like you only fought him one time. At least in the main story. I don't know about in Trip's story. And then there's this little gimmick in there where you can like build your own Metal Sonic, but mix and match parts from all kinds of different things. And then one of the level bosses is that little robot that you build, which I kind of see where they were going with that, but ultimately it was just the same Metal Sonic fight that we've already had. The giant laser is destroying the platforms. You're constantly running, so it's an auto-scroller. He does his attacks. You whack him a couple of times. Then he goes into the giant, I can't think of what it was called, but the giant version of Metal Sonic, where he's chasing you and has the lasers and all that. It was kind of cool because you could pick the colors of each body part, so you're kind of customizing a level boss, but you only see him one time. It'd be different if, like, he came back a couple of times, like, you kept defeating him, but no, you beat him that one time, then you never see him again. And then after that, there's no point in customizing. Like, I had only customized the legs and the arms up until that point. So it had Metal Sonic's feet, Metal Knuckles' little blade hand things. And the rest of it, the body and the head, was just the generic blank robot. It's kind of lame. I touched on the controls and the physics in the last episode, but just to reiterate, all the characters feel exactly the same. I mostly played as Sonic, but it forces you to play as Knuckles, Tails, and Amy in certain levels. They all feel the same. Now, their double jump abilities are different. So, obviously, Tails can fly. Knuckles does his glide. Sonic has the drop dash. And Amy has her hammer spin. But they all feel pretty much the same. They all feel like they go the same speed, which is kind of slow. When you jump, the arc of the jump is very floaty, like you go a lot farther than you think you're going to do, and when you try to pull it back, it falls a lot shorter than you want it to. Like, getting it, like, dead center where you want it, I played the whole game and I still never got it exactly dialed in. When you start to fall, these characters fall like a lead brick. I mean, it's like, boom. So it's like a weird floatiness mixed with heavy. Kind of reminded me of Sonic episode or Sonic 4 episode 1 and 2. So when it comes to Sonic Superstars, again, I would recommend just casually playing it if you're a Sonic fan. If you're not a Sonic fan, this is definitely a skip. I mean, just playing it because it's a platformer? No, it's not a very good platformer. I still don't know what I'm going to do for a rating system, but I guess for the sake of like a 1 to 10 rating system, 10 being the best, 1 being absolute garbage, honestly, I'd probably give this a 4. There weren't very many times where I was even really having fun with it. But I kept playing it thinking that, like, okay, the next level is going to be where it gets good. And that level kind of sucked too. All right, the next one's got to be good though, right? Because, I mean, like, even like Sonic 3 and Knuckles combined, I am not a fan of Sandopolis at all. I don't like Flying Battery Zone. But the rest of the game is really good. So, when I get to Flying Battery Zone, yeah, it kind of brings me down. But, I mean, I was having fun in Ice Cap and even Carnival Night Zone. So one level does not make a bad game, but this is just a bad game. Honestly, I hope the next 2D Sonic that we get goes back to the Mania formula, because I mean, Mania was great. But like right here, this is on Wikipedia, but it's talking about Christian Whitehead and Takashi Iizuka, who developed this. They did not want to make a Mania sequel since Iizuka felt the casual audience would dismiss it as a refresh. He wanted to abandon Mania's pixel art, as Mania had been intended for hardcore Sonic fans, and he thought a new 2D game needed to appeal to a broad audience. I understand the need to bring in new people, but do you not understand all the fails of the Sonic legacy if you push your hardcore fans away? Eventually, they are going to stop being fans. They're not going to carry the flag for you. They're the ones that are going to bring in the new people, because they're going to be like, hey, I just played this fucking awesome game. It's called Sonic Superstar. I got to get my buddy over here and make him play it. But that's not the case with this game. I mean, I know people that when Mania came out, the hype was so there that people that were not Sonic fans became Sonic fans for that one game. Because Sonic Forces, they jumped on that and they were like, this is nowhere near what it was. And then those same people got Sonic Origins and they're kind of like iffy on that, because even though Sonic Origins is the classic games, they did change some things. And some of it was not necessarily for the better. But Sonic Origins is a different discussion altogether. So yeah, I guess that's where I'm going to end it with the Sonic Superstar review. Like I said, it's like a 4. In comparison, Sonic 3 and Knuckles, that's probably like a 9. So there you go. Well, let's jump into some quick 2024 predictions. I think this is probably going to be the year where we see the new Nintendo console. We're not going to get it this year. But I think the Switch 2 or the Super Switch or whatever it's going to be, I think this is the year where we're going to get that debut trailer. Probably it'll come out next year. And if I had to guess, it's probably going to be before the holiday season, probably like September-ish. But that's pushing it way further than I want to. But yeah, I think we're going to get the Super Switch, the Switch 2, the Switch Ultra, the Switch 64, whatever they're going to call it. Because, I mean, that system is almost 10 years old now. I know Nintendo kind of runs to the beat of their own drum, but the system is old, and I think having to co-develop on the Switch as well as the PS5 and the Xbox Series S/X, I think the Switch is what's holding games back the most. The Series S is also holding games back, but that's a completely different topic as well. I think probably pretty early in this year, we're either going to get a look at Resident Evil 9 or Resident Evil Code Veronica Remake. I would love to see both, but I think we're only going to get one. And I'm kind of leaning more towards Code Veronica Remake. Just because they've already got a lot of, like, they've already got Claire built up. Her assets are in Resident Evil 2. I don't think it would take much more to make a game from there. Like, they've already got the engine. They know how it works. They've got the character models, or a couple of the character models already done. And plus, I mean, Code Veronica hasn't even been re-released since the Xbox 360 PS3 era. So that was two generations ago now. And I mean, Capcom, when it comes to Resident Evil series, they actually seem to be listening to the fans now. And the fans have been saying, we want Code Veronica. Me personally, I've tried to play Code Veronica, like going back and trying to play it. I don't think I can play any of the classic games with the tank controls and all that now that I played all the remakes. Plus, when it transitioned into Resident Evil 4 originally, and they made it more of an over-the-shoulder thing, I just can't go back from that. I've tried. I really have. Let's see, what else do I think is going to happen? Well, we know E3's dead, so I'm pretty sure there won't be any more E3 prediction videos. But then again, you got Jeff Keighley's Summer Game Fest, which is basically E3 now. Let me take a quick look at my games library and see if anything pops out. I know one more thing I want to predict but that has to be last. I know it would be nice if we got a second trailer for GTA 6, like, towards the end of the year. Ah, nothing's really jumping out. Absolutely nothing at all. All right, so that leaves me to my last 2024 prediction. And this is like a one or the other. I don't think we'll get both. But it would be amazing if we did. I think we get an HD remaster of Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie. And if that does well, I think that paves the path to get Banjo-3E. I think that's probably a good Summer Games Fest world premiere thing. And they could do something cheeky, like start it off making it look like it's a Sea of Thieves thing. But then you have Blubber steering the ship. And then there's like, I don't know, like a hurricane or something that picks the whole ship up and blows it away. And then that's your shipwrecked ship in Treasure Trove Cove. And then that's how the trailer starts. And then it's, you see Mumbo and Bottles and all them. And oh, that would be so fucking good. All right, so that's going to wrap up this episode. If you're catching this on YouTube, make sure to hit that subscribe button and check either the description box or the show notes for links to the Patreon and some affiliate links to some different products that I use that if you want to use them too, use those links and it helps me out. Anyway, let's stop.